Well, guys, the time has come. My dad and I are looking at buying a tractor. Any guesses? Well, guys, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all. Welcome to Hartung Family Farms. And today, Ron's here. I am up in Dubuque, Iowa right now at a dealership, and I'm going to do some shopping. Put your guesses in the comment section right now down below. What do you think? What do you think I should get for a tractor? What do you think my dad and I should get for a tractor? What do you think we're here looking for? What do you guys think? So I'm up here, kind of south end of Dubuque, Iowa, and I'm going to drive around and do some looking. So you guys can kind of see we're at a red dealership. A lot of nice combines up here, 7088, 26140s. If it was an 8240, I'd look at that for the farm, but nothing here. A Hardy sprayer, you do not see a lot of these self-propelled Hardy sprayers. A Presutu, neat. These are actually assembled in Davenport, Iowa, like a mile from my house. That's kind of neat. A bale mover, don't see a ton of them around, but that'd be handy. There's a draper, some construction equipment, a nice black stripe 1066. We gotta get out and look at this one. This thing looks cool. No loader on it, I'm definitely not interested. Let's just see how many hours are on it. Can't tell, so that's not good. Ballparking 4,000 to 8,000. It's got LED lights on it, or at least that one was. Sweet, nice little black stripe. That's for sale. Brand new J&M grain cart, looks like a 875. Oh. So I'm just gonna walk around right now. I don't know if the guy will let me film. I'm gonna meet a salesman up here. Mahindra. Interesting. You don't see a ton of Mahindras. So I am meeting a salesman, but I doubt he'll let me film with him. So I'm just gonna drive around right now, just do some looking, go in and meet with him, and then come back here. Ooh, RB565 Premium. That's brand new. Mikhail is a ripper. 8930. So there's a lot of good tractors up in here. Do you guys got any guesses on what do you guys think we'll be liking? Look kind of neat. Kubota. Never driven one of them. 340 Magnum. A 150 Maxim. Look at that gleaner. Brian. Your dad would love this thing. An R40. Oof. So there's a lot of tractors back here, guys. So what are you guys' guesses? What do you think we're gonna be looking at? That's a nice looking tractor. Oh, I don't like how, I think that front's kind of ugly, if I'm being honest. Ugh. Well, that one's, yeah, I've never liked that front of that Kubota. I mean, it wouldn't be a deal breaker on a tractor, I'm just saying I don't like it. Kind of is nice though, because you know, one thing I struggle with on our loaders is if the lights are all on the same angle, if your loader is like right on there, well, you can't see anything. So it is kind of nice that the lights are on two different heights, but still it kind of looks ugly to me. Well, just driving around the deal lot, brand new 12 row corn head there, a couple rippers, there's a vertical till, a brand new planter, 1255. TMR mixers, lots of cool stuff. So let's head in, let's go talk to some people, maybe film some, maybe not. And then I'll come back here and walk around and see, actually get in some of these tractors and see what ones we like. All right, let's take a look at this Kubota M6111. All right, so there's an M6111 and an M6141. The M6141 is sold. Let's take a look at this thing. And it's locked. Oh crap. Well, let's keep driving around. We'll see. Never driven a Kubota before. Never actually been in one, period. You guys ever tried one? I'm usually used to, you know, those. Look at the fat tires on that thing. Look at these little guys. Aww. Nice little bucket. So this M6 141 is sold. Also locked. I think these sizes would be about right on what we would want. What my dad and I are really looking for is we're looking for a tractor that is about 100 horse at the PTO, 85 to 100 horse at the PTO, about 120 engine horse. It's got to have a loader on it. It's got to be able to lift wet bales, so 5,000 pounds or so. Well, probably not that much, but it's got to be able to lift a good amount. So I think this 111 would probably work. This 141 for sure would. There's some good case tractors over there. Let's go take a look at. I did not know New Holland made a side slinger type of tractor or type of manure spreader. A Dura tank. Interesting. Yeah, did not know that. You guys ever run one before? This looks a little beat up, but. Ooh, I didn't even notice. Look at all these skid steers. You got some old cases, bobcats, newer cases. Ooh, a Terex. Nice. Never driven one, but that looks heavy duty there. Looks like a forest package. Gales, Kubotas. I think Kubota skid steers aren't bad. So here we go. We got a 340, an older style, because you can kind of see there's a new cab, there's the old cabs, but so they had the same model numbers. So you can get a 340 like ours, but you can definitely tell there's a break when they got new cabs. I don't know the exact year, but I want to say it was like 2015-ish. No, later than that, 2016. So that's the newer cabs. That's a 200, 340, Steiger 450. Here we go. Here's a 340. 340, 340. But you can definitely tell they're different though, just because of the cab. So that's how you know they're different model years. Here's an older Kubota, M135GX. It's kind of interesting. It's got weights in the front. So I'm just kind of window shopping right now. I'm gonna get out and look at, I already looked at that Kubota. I'm gonna get out and look at the couple of these case ones. I don't know. The Kubota might be in our weight range. We will see. Just kind of all depends. Dude, look at that duck. It's a Steiger road track. Neat. All right, let's have a look at this thing. So it looks like a Farmall 75A. Looks like two Farmall 75As, brand new. This is interesting. I don't know how I feel about that. So it's got a buddy seat, which that Kubota did not have. Smaller cab. So it looks like a four range. Oh, it looks like, so it's not a power shift. Let me shut this. So I like the amount of glass in the cab, but I think we're overall, right away, I don't think this tractor's gonna be big enough to handle what we want it to handle. Cause like, so we wanna get a tractor to basically replace the 1566. So we need it to move bales. We need it to rake for sure. Maybe pull the disc spine, maybe not. It definitely won't pull the baler, that's for sure. And then, feed hay and plow snow. That's what we need a tractor for. And full front wheel assist is an absolute must. So we're looking at tractors right now, or at least I am. So right away I can already tell I do not like this. So here's your throttle. Everything's kind of scattered. Like it's not really grouped very well. It looks like you got three ranges. One, two, and three, and then four gears within that range. So it's not a power shift. Here's your loader. I don't like how this thing's way out here. I do not like that whatsoever. Yeah, so even if this tractor was bigger, I do not like the cab enough. I don't know. I think I'd pass on this thing. So it's a Farmall 75A. Farmall's probably, I don't know if it's the brand, if it's like the series number, like you know how Chevy, GMC, Cadillac, whatever, they're different series number for different sizes. I think how Case does it, where Farmall is like their smaller ones, Maxim's like their medium size, Magnum's their big size, they have a Puma as well. So I think they have different numbers for different names for different frame sizes. So this is definitely smaller. I don't think it'll work because it's A, too small, and B, I just don't like it. So let's hop out then. But I do like it as a buddy seat. And the buddy seat's tucked up in there pretty nicely. How would someone sit? Let me sit in this buddy seat. Oh. Oh, wow. Okay, it's nice that it has a buddy seat, but this must be just for like little kids, because no way two grown adults would fit in here. But granted, this is a small tractor. It's probably not the typical use case for two grown adults to sit in here. Now what would be nice is this 150 Maxim. But I'm gonna tell you right now, that's out of our price range. It's fully weighted, got the new cab, brand new. It's got the new style lights, or grill, I should say. That's pretty nice. Sweet. So yeah, that would be really nice, but I guarantee it's out of our price range. You don't see a lot of two-wheel drive tractors anymore. Especially brand new ones you don't see. So that's got the new Maxim grill. There's highway 61 right here. So I don't know. We'll see, but there are a couple tractors in here that are pretty decent. I like that Kubota. That was probably the number one. That was probably the front runner, I'd have to say, out of all these. But what do you guys think would be a great tractor for my dad and I to buy? If we need like 100 to 120 engine, 80 to 90 PTO horsepower, 80 to 100 PTO horsepower, that's minimum. We need front wheel assist, we need a loader, because as I said before, that we want to use it to rake hay for sure, move bales, feed cattle, and push snow. It needs to be a cab, so it needs to be newer-ish. So what do you guys think? Hey, look, a McHale. Never seen those before. Ooh, this thing would be nice. A bale shredder, bale processor. We need one of these at some point for the farm. Cat MT575D, sweet. So I think I'm gonna head back home. I got some homework to do. I got some videos to edit. I got like 5 videos made that I need to be edited. So I'm gonna head home, guys. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Ooh, 6150 combine. I love the paint job on these things. So anyway, I'm gonna head home, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed this style of video. We are going to be purchasing a tractor if everything works out right in the next couple months, so stay tuned for that. By we, I mean my dad and I, so that'll be interesting. I know we got some purchases coming on the farm. And we'll see what happens with that harvest store video here. But anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you guys did, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Follow us on Facebook and Instagram on Heart Tongue Family Farms. And of course, guys, as always, ta-ta for now.